Hi, guess what's inside this box? I bought a DIY 3D printer from China for 18,000 rupees and rupees 3,000 for customs duty. So in total, I bought this printer for 21,000 rupees. Now let's open this and see what's inside. Before you continue to watch this video, make sure you have watched the video on 3D printing I made for CyberNIP's YouTube channel. The links are provided below. A company called ZoneStar manufactured this printer, and this is a dual extrusion printer, which means you can print an object in two colors or one color with a support structure which you may dissolve later to avoid overhangs. The consignment comes neatly in many separate compartments with unique markings. Let's take a quick look at the components of this consignment. This compartment has a package labeled A4 and it contains a memory card that has a 512 MB memory, which is sufficient for printing purposes. A spare motor driver module, some cables for connecting the stepper motors with the controller board, and a temperature sensor for the hot end module. The next compartment contains 6 units of stepper motors. 4 of them are NEMA 17 motors that have a shaft length of 23 mm and 2 of them are NEMA 17 motors that have a shaft length of 16 mm. Next, there is a dual nozzle hot end module that is fortunately pre-assembled. This would have been a most complex module to assemble by hand. It has 2 linear bearings that help to move the hot end module in x-axis. There are 2 cooling fans as well. The nozzles have a diameter of 0.4 mm that helps in producing prints with greater detail. Here we have some nuts and bolts of different sizes in a nice plastic box. You can see the respective sizes of the screws and nuts on your screen. Next, we have an LCD display module which also houses the memory card slot and a buzzer. This model can display the characters in 4 rows. The printer can be controlled by the 5-button keypad which is also present in the LCD module. There is a masking tape which helps while printing the object without causing any damage to the heat bed. And we got few grams of red and blue printer filaments. Then there is a USB type B cable. So we can use this cable to connect the printer to a computer and we can control the printer directly through the software. There's a package named C2 that has motor timing belts, AC power switch, cable ties, a pair of 60 cm PTFE tube through which we can feed the filament. There is an aluminium foil, I don't know its purpose. Then we have PE pipe envelope tube wire insulation. We can use this to wrap all the wires. This will make the wirings look good. Another package labeled as A2 has a Z-axis screw lead pair that helps in moving the hot end along Z-axis. And we have a Y-axis motor support, a pulley that can be attached to the front frame and helps in moving the base plate. We also got an end stop frame. Then we have a pair of Z-axis slider parts labeled as B3. Next, there are some linear bearings, a pulley, and couplings that can be attached to the motor shaft for hot end movement. This package has some extruder parts for filament retraction. Here is a filament holder that is made up of acrylic. This is an optional gift, so some of you may not receive it. Next, we have some cables of various lengths for connecting the stepper motor to the controller board. Then we have the X and Y axis end stop and an LCD cable. Here we have a proximity sensor. It can detect metals. It can help the printer's computer program to compensate for the minute irregularities in the base plate alignment. There is a package named B1 and it contains some Allen key spanner, screwdriver, and a diagonal plier. Next we have a power cable and a neatly CNC milled metal frames for all sides including a heat bed support frame. The stainless steel looks gorgeous. Then we got 2 threaded lead screws and 4 lead rods with holes in them and 2 lead rods without holes. Here is the controller board. This board is compatible with the RepRap Arduino Mega Pololo Shield, also known as the RAMS version 1.4 for the 3D printer and CNC devices. It has an ATmega 2560 microcontroller, which is Arduino compatible, and this board can accept voltages between 12V and 24V DC. You can update the firmware of this controller as well. Here is a power supply unit that outputs 12V at 20 amps max. It also has input voltage setting for use in different parts of the world. I'm in India, so I'm switching it to 220V AC. We can adjust the output voltage using the trim port near the screw terminals. Here we have the heat bed of size 220 by 220 by 3 mm. This guy can go up to 110 degrees Celsius. So these are all the parts we got in this consignment. Let's start assembling this printer in part 2. Thanks for watching this video. See you again.